Turn your ear, O Lord, and answer me. Save the servant who trusts in you, my God. Have mercy on me, O Lord, for I cry to you all the day long. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Acknowledging our human weakness and our faults, for the times we may have fallen asleep to the call of God to respond to Him. Let us turn to Him with a humble and contrite heart to seek His mercy and forgiveness. growing with its new converts, its new members that were baptized. And Paul, being Paul, as Paul is, Paul writes to encourage them. Paul is trying to spur them, that flame, that fan, that flame in the church of Thessalonica. And when Paul is writing this, Thessalonica today is it's northern of Greece, you know. And then Paul is writing this, he's just got a report from Timothy on his return back of how the church is growing. And that is why Paul writes to this church and says, your life, your very life, is very much an encouragement for us in this part of the world when we are struggling. The kind of life that you live night and day spurs us on as much as we spur you on to live this gospel. It's words of encouragement. It's words that edifies one another in this Christian life. This past days, we've been talking on the theme of choices and decisions and how this shapes, colors, molds the path of our life every day. And what is important is how do we keep ourselves on this journey? Because there's always this temptation to move away, to slowly step away from that path, that decisions that we have made to follow Christ. How do we persevere in that decisions? How do we manage that decision? And that was what St. Paul was trying to tell them. Keep that faith. Keep it going. Paul was trying to strengthen that decision that this early church in Thessalonica had embarked on. And the key or the secret to step into this consistency, this perseverance of this decision, is what Jesus says, stay awake at all times. That's the secret of today's gospel. To stay awake at the decisions that you have made. Because the temptation is sometimes to slowly fall asleep at that decisions. To slowly to be tempted by many things in life that you fall away from the decisions that we have made in life. And it's interesting when you step into this parable, the story of these two kinds of servants, the faithful, prudent ones, the dishonest, wicked ones. That's how Jesus pictures this servanthood with the master's relationship. We can fall into any one of those moments in our lives. There are days when we find ourselves filled with that responsibility, filled with that discipline, filled with the enthusiasm and zeal to work and to wait for that moment of that decisions that we have taken on. And there are the days when we tell ourselves, it's good to take a break. It's good to just let things be as they are. And slowly we lose that path, we lose that focus, and all of a sudden we have lost that path. This word, awake, stay awake, you find it in scriptures. The Latin translation or the Greek translation simply means to be alert. Another word is vigilant, to be vigilant at all times. That means you are totally awake, alert, and attuned to what is happening in your spiritual life. Because sometimes in the spiritual path, we may fall asleep. We may fall asleep. And when you fall asleep, you've lost it. You have lost the very presence of God. As we step into this beautiful day, and when we stay awake at God's presence, because there's two things that I just would like to invite you this morning to stay with when you're awake. When you are awake in your life, you will see God at work. You will see God at work in your life. And when God is when God is awake and awake in your life, two things happens. There's two things. happy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Sebastian, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her husband, the Blessed Apostles, with Saint Faustina and John Paul II, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, to praise and to glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Take a moment to offer that peace to one another.